So we are going to see about stress. I am 11L and this work is under Creative Commons license CC by SA. Why study stress and strain? Stress and strain are the cause and effect respectively in deformable bodies. Say we call something as rigid body. It is a body of zero deformation. It is impossible and it is theoretical that an absolute rigid body exists. All bodies are deformable. So how much and how are what we are interested in. Applied force and reaction. Deformation is change in dimensions. The change may be in shape or size or both. Deformation takes place when force is applied. Applied force is an external force. It can be a single force. It can be multiple forces on several directions also. For the applied forces, there are definite reactions. Reaction force. Reactions are of several types, and one such reaction are the internal forces. When external forces are resisted, internal forces are set up. They have to be equal in magnitude and opposite in direction according to Newton's third law. Internal force, as its name suggests, acts inside the body. So here we have a set of graphical representations. The first one, we see a tensile force acting on a body as an external force. The same tension is acting inside the body in opposite direction as an internal force or a reaction force. Similarly, we have in the third figure a compressive force acting externally on a body, and in the fourth figure we have the corresponding reactive internal force acting as a compression. Though the directions shown in external and internal forces are different, they are all same. Internal force distribution. So in uniform cross-section, internal force is evenly distributed. In irregular or varying cross-sections, force is unevenly distributed. Here, the external force or the vectorial sum of external forces, if a number of forces are acting upon, is equal to the vectorial sum of internal forces acting throughout the body. These internal forces bring out deformation. Stress. Internal force creates deformations proportional to its concentration in a section. This internal force concentration is called as stress. Stress is defined as the total internal force acting on unit area of cross-section. Only as a special case, on uniform cross-section with single force, stress value is numerically equal to external force divided by area. This should not be confused. This is only a special case. Deformations produced. External force per unit area is intensity of pressure and should not be called stress. Stress values at every localized area creates local deformations. Total deformation is the net effect of individual deformations. Again, in uniform bodies, deformation can be calculated from external force values, though they are actually produced by internal forces. Importance of stress. Amount of force alone doesn't decide the amount of deformation. The stress value that the force produces decides the amount of deformation. 100 Newton force acting on a body of cross section 20 square mm can produce more deformation on a body of same material where 500 newton force is acting on a cross section of 200 square mm, and this is due to the corresponding stress values produced. Not only on quantity of deformation, but a number of conditions are attained in a material based on stress values as follows: elastic deformation, plastic deformation, yielding, maximum load bearing, neck formation, failure, and etc. Stress is the most important factor that decides what happens to a deformable material. Stress dominates any scenario.